Hello everyone, today we will study about reference electrodes. In the last video we have seen how the electrode potential difference can be calculated. Okay, now what is reference electrode? Electrodes which are used as a standard known as reference electrode, and the basic function of this reference electrode is to maintain a constant electrical potential against which any deviation can be measured. Okay, so reference electrode should possess some characteristic. They should possess mainly two characteristic. That is, first one, it should be easy to construct, and the second one, it should develop potential which are reproducible even if small currents are passed. Okay, so these two properties or characters should be present in a reference electrode. Now we will see the examples of reference electrode. So the first one is hydrogen electrode. It consists of a piece of platinum leaf or foil which is dipped in 1.18 molar solution of hydrogen ions, and the solution used to provide this hydrogen ion activity is, as I have already told you, 1.18 molar hydrogen chloride. And to increase its surface area, the platinum foil is coated with platinum black, and hydrogen gas at 1 atmospheric pressure is bubbled over this foil, and this arrangement in toto is known as standard hydrogen electrode, and it is assigned a potential of 0 under all conditions. That means the potential of this hydrogen electrode is always 0. Okay, it is assigned 0. Here this is the diagram for hydrogen electrode. You can see here this is the platinum foil or leaf that is coated with platinum black, and here this is the inflow of hydrogen gas, and this is the outflow for gas, and the solution which present is hydrogen chloride, that is of 1.18 molar. Okay, now we can measure the pH of any unknown solution if two hydrogen electrodes are immersed into two solution, and the EMF, electron motive force, or electrode potential developed in such a system will be an index of hydrogen ion concentration in the unknown solution. So we can calculate the pH of any unknown solution with the help of this formula, that is pH is equal to electron motive force generated divided by 0.059. If the potential difference, that is the electron motive force between the standard hydrogen electrode and the electrode in unknown solution is experimentally determined, that means we can determine the value of this EMF through experiment, then we can know the pH of any unknown solution. Okay, now the second one, reference electrode, is the Calomel reference electrode. The electrode, this electrode is consist of a strip of platinum sealed into glass and allowed to dip into mercury. You can see here this is the platinum wire which is dipped into mercury, and the paste of Calomel, that is mercury chloride, is held against the mercury by means of cotton wool. You can see here this is the cotton wool, and against which mercury chloride, that is known as Calomel, is there. Now the whole electrode, this whole electrode is filled with saturated KCl. You can see here this is the side arm for filling the potassium chloride solution, and it is saturated with potassium chloride, and here is the potassium chloride crystals are also present. Okay, and contact with outside electrolyte is maintained through a porous ceramic plug. Okay, so we did this porous ceramic plug into outside electrolyte, so that they may connect with the outside solution. Okay, now the Calomel is a half cell, and it is represented at like this: platinum, then interface mercury, then interface mercury chloride, interface then potassium chloride solution saturated. So this each vertical line that shows interface, actually at this interface potential is developed, and the primary reaction that is responsible for development of potential difference is mercuric ion accept two electrons and converted into mercury, and we can calculate the pH with the help of this Calomel reference electrode with the help of this formula, that is pH is equal to E minus 0.246 divided by 0.059. here 0.246 is the potential difference of Calomel electrode, which is calculated with the help of hydrogen electrode. So we minus this value from the overall EMF generated in the electrode when two electrodes are connected. So with the help of this formula, we can calculate the pH of any unknown solution. Okay, now this Calomel reference electrode is very easy to prepare, and it generally used as reference electrode, whereas hydrogen electrode is not easy to maintain because here we have to flow the hydrogen gas at a constant pressure. That is very difficult to maintain that pressure, so it is rarely used. Whereas it is used to determine the electrode potential of other reference electrodes. Okay, now the third one is the silver-silver chloride electrode. The silver-silver chloride electrode is consist of a metallic silver wire that is coated with silver chloride. Here this is the silver wire that is coated with silver chloride and immersed in a saturated potassium chloride solution. Here again is the side on for filling potassium chloride solution, and it is saturated with potassium chloride solution. And here some pieces of potassium chloride are put over here, and this is the ceramic plug which helps to connect with the outside solution. Okay, now the primary reaction that is responsible for generation of potential difference in this silver silver chloride electrode is the silver chloride accept electrons and it converted into silver plus chloride ion. Okay, so the potential developed in the silver silver chloride electrode may be calculated from the Nernst equation as we have seen in the previous video, and when we put all the values we get this final equation, that is EMF generated through this electrode is 0.222 minus 0.0509 and log of chloride ion concentration. So you can see here the potential difference generated in silver silver chloride electrode is mainly